One day in the sixth grade, I got in trouble for talking too much, so I got sent to the principal's office, and the principal looked at me as if he wanted to kill me. He told me to sit down and wait while he handled some business, and a while after he came back and told me to go back to class, but I felt like something was off, so I asked him if everything was okay, and he stared me down and told me to leave. I was so sad. I went home crying, and I told my mom about what happened, and she explained to me that they were dating and she broke his heart. I was in shock. The next day at school, I went to his office and gave him a piece of my mind, because what my mom does has nothing to do with me, and he slowly walked towards me, and I got a little nervous because he is so fucking hot. Like, I would let this man have my babies. He grabbed me by my waist and asked me if I wanted to do the dirty. Obviously I said yes, and he told me to take off my clothes, so I took off my clothes, and I was so ready. Then he just stood there, so I asked him what he was waiting for, and he took out his phone and took a picture of me, then said that he was going to expose me if I didn't help.
I literally want to cry. So if you didn't know, I have a sister and her name's Ashley, and we both have boyfriends, and every night we both fall asleep on the phone with our boyfriends. So one day we're all hanging out and we're like just talking, and my sister's boyfriend looks at me and he's like, "You need to stop going into your sister's room in the middle of the night." And I look at him and I'm like, what are you talking about? I don't have a reason to go into her room. Like, I don't go into her room, especially in the middle of the night. Then my boyfriend hops in the conversation and he's like, no, 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 no. He's like, no, I hear Ashley go into Kayla's room every night and stare at her. So me and my sister both look at each other and we're like, we don't go into each other's rooms, do we? And we agreed that we do not. And they said this has been going on for months. So for months, somebody or something has been going into me and my sister's room for about 15 minutes every night and watching us sleep. But it only gets worse.
Story time about my psychotic best friend. So we're gonna call this girl Gia. So a little background information. This all happened whenever I was in 9th grade. I saw Gia sitting at this lunch table alone, and I invited her to come sit with my friends and I. And after talking to her, I found out that she was a new student and she didn't have any friends. So her and I started hanging out and we became really close. Like, she would come over my house 24/7. Well, my older sister was a grade above us, and she would act really weird around her. And by weird, I mean like she would always make fun of me in front of my sister, and weirdly enough, try to cause problems between us. My sister didn't really like her. She thought that she was weird, but because she was my friend, she was being super nice to her. Well, like a month later, she started trying to become best friends with my sister. Like, any conversation she would have, I would be like, oh, do you want to come over? She would be like, no, sorry, I'm hanging out with your sister today. And I would go home and I would be like, hey, are you hanging out with Gia today? And my sister would be like, what the hell are you talking about? Like, for part two.
Story time. I babysat a lot of kids in my neighborhood, and there was this one night that I was babysitting a two-year-old. It was around 10 o'clock at night, so the kid was sleeping, and I was just sitting in the living room. In the living room, there was a big TV, a couch, and then behind me, it was a wall with a giant window. So it was really late at night, I had nothing to do, so I was Snapchatting my friends. If you Snapchat anybody, I'm sure you know that sometimes you Snapchat really fast. You don't even know or look at what you're sending. I was mass snapping all my friends, and then one of them replied 10 minutes later. And he said, "Who's that guy behind you?" And I turned around and no one was there, so I'm like, he's playing a joke on me. But then I get another Snapchat from this friend I had, and she lives all the way across the country. They don't know each other. And she said, "I think there's someone outside." So I was really freaked out because I was alone, there was a giant window behind me, apparently there was someone outside. I wasn't gonna call the child's parents because I didn't want to freak them out, but I was scared. So then I went around the house, locked all of the doors. Sorry, it's a really long story, like for part two.
Story time about the time a nail salon took advantage of my blindness. Sister and I got our nails done. We used to go all the time. And while the lady was doing my nails, she asked me how I knew how much money I had. At the time, I used cash, never again after this. But I told her that I folded my bills a certain way. I told her that I folded my 20s, different than my 10s, different than my 5s, different than my 1s. Anything of her asking that question, I think it's a good question. And I just thought she was curious. I got done with my nails. She walked me towards the front, and my sister was actually just finishing up with hers. So it was perfect. There's another man at the front, and he asked me how I knew how much money I had. I told him the same thing. Before I left to go to the nail salon, I made sure exactly how much money I had. My sister helped me count it, helped me make sure that I folded the right bills, just so I knew how much I had, how much I would spend. I gave her the money. Positive that I gave her the right amount because it was just folded. It was folded perfectly and I counted it out. She takes it, starts talking in a different language, and then tells me that I owe her $20 more. I didn't, and I told her the exact amount I gave her, and she's like, no, you didn't give me this amount, you gave me that amount. Like for part two.
Girls, tell me about a time where your quick thinking probably saved your life. I'll go first. 2 years ago, I was walking my dog at the park and a man approached me and asked to take a picture of her. And I said yes, because why not? It's a picture of a dog. So he starts taking a picture of my dog, and then I realized that he was like holding up her collar, and then it hit me. My address is on that collar. He's not taking a picture of my dog. He's taking a picture of my address. So I told him that I actually didn't feel comfortable with him having a picture of my dog, and I asked him to delete it. So he deletes it and then like starts walking away really fast. And I was like, excuse me, sir. No, could you also go into your deleted album and delete it from there? And he goes, I don't have a deleted album. And I was like, you have an iPhone. Everybody has a deleted album. Could you please delete the picture? And he was like, sorry, I don't have a deleted album, and like keeps walking away. And keep in mind, this is like 2 p.m. in a park. Like there's other people around. So now I'm like chasing after him and I'm telling him, sir, I know you have the album. I will show you where the album is. Can you please go onto your phone so that we can delete the picture? Oh, part two.
I'm gonna tell you guys about the time that my entire class teamed up to take my teacher down. And by down, I mean fired, which is terrible, but... And to be clear, I wasn't involved in the incident. I was just asked in to be a witness along with the rest of the class. If you're not interested at this point, like, I don't even know. So when I was in sixth grade, I had this teacher called Mr. W. We're gonna call him Mr. W. He was our science teacher. And he was fine. He wasn't, like, amazing or bad. He was just okay. He did smell, like, really, really bad. But again, that didn't affect his teaching at all. One day, however, I don't even know how this happened. He asked us all to get started on our work. He was a little irritated that day. I don't even remember why. One of the girls in our class, her name was Summer, she didn't have her workbook. Mr. W asked her where her work was. I didn't bring it today. They started arguing. The rest of the class was kind of silent, just watching this. She's a nice girl. She wasn't attacking him or anything. He did, however, get very angry. So angry, in fact, that he grabbed his binder and threw it across the room over her head. It just barely skipped her head and slammed on the floor. This wasn't like an empty binder from the dollar store. It was a teacher binder full of work. We were all silent. Summer stopped talking. Look for part two.
Part two. I'm sorry for the delay. So I'm still chasing after him, and people at the park are like starting to look at us now because I'm chasing after him and I'm telling him to stop walking. And so he stops, and I tell him again to delete the photo from the deleted album, and he goes, I don't have a deleted album. And I was like, yes, you do. Everybody does. It'll take 10 seconds. And he goes, fine. And he like goes in his phone, does something for a second. He goes, there, it's gone. And I was like, could I see the deleted album just to make sure it's gone? And he goes, no, you can't look at my phone. And I was like, I don't want to look at your phone. I just want to see the album just to make sure the picture is gone. That's it. And he goes, no, you're not going to look at my phone. And I was like, sir, I'm not going to stop and I'm not going to leave until you show me the album. So please just show me the album so we can be done with this. So he shows me the album. The picture was still there. So I made him delete it in front of my eyes. What if I hadn't noticed that he took a picture of my address? And what if I went home that day and, you know, that night when I took my dog out to pee, he was outside waiting for me? I mean...
Story time on the time I had to go pick up my sister, who went to Manhattan an hour away and didn't tell my parents. So basically, my sister asked my parents if she could go to her friend's house, which was 5 minutes away. So they came and they picked her up and took her to their house. Fast forward 2 hours later, my parents tell me to pick her up and bring her back home. So I text her and I'm like, where are you at? I'm gonna come pick you up in 5 minutes. This girl texts me and is like, Mash, I'm not there. I'm in the city. I'm an hour away. Oh my God. And I'm like, you stupid bitch. So I had to drive to the city, which was an hour away, and I had to drive back. And my parents told me to also get my Starbucks drink, so I had to go there on top of that. So we were freaking out in the car because my mom has a tracker on her phone, and she turned it off, and she called my brother, so we thought she knew. But then when we got home, she didn't know.